When I sat down to write a script for a little video about a short hike, all I could think about was, what am I going to say about this beautiful little game and its potential impact on a player's emotional well-being that I haven't said before about other really sweet hedonic games, or that someone hasn't already said in general? I've already talked so much about how studies show that these calm, sweet, and encouraging games help us recover from stress and emotional strain, which is all true, but then I started to fixate on how I had already cited the authors of those studies so many times it feels redundant and maybe even annoying to any viewers interested in fresh research. All I knew was that this game did something important for me. It helped me, and it deserves even more praises to be sung for it, even from my little corner. But I just couldn't think of how to do it justice. I kept trying to find new angles to approach the game, and felt like giving up and just filing it with all the others in the "I love this game, but I just don't know how to write about it yet" folder. But then I realized something. This exact feeling is what the game helped me with. The "it's not good enough, what do I have to offer" feeling. So, to calm my mind before writing, I took another short hike, and here's what I realized that I wanted to share. Every time I loaded up the game, I would find myself smiling the entire time I played it. With the gentle, swaying music that sounds like some of my favorite pieces by Joe Hisaishi, the adorable characters, clever dialogue, and free exploration gameplay made the pocket-sized island feel bountiful and interesting. You run wherever your curiosity takes you, and you don't know what's waiting for you around the next hill or peak, but you know it's going to be adorable and refreshing. When it comes to discussing the mental or emotional benefits of playing video games, I'm very careful to always back up my statements with peer-reviewed sources, especially because of the stigma and moral panic surrounding games. But for anyone who has played this game, it seems like common sense to say that it can bolster our short-term sense of well-being. Studies show that one of the most efficient and rewarding ways to recover from stress is not only to rest, but to actively engage with calm, sweet, and hedonic media like a short hike. While playing games like this, we quickly shed the stressors of our life and our sympathetic system relaxes, so we benefit from jumping into a world that encourages curiosity, wonder, and quiet gratitude. Playing this after a tough day at work, I could feel the weight and tension slip off my shoulders. Suddenly, nothing mattered more than finding treasure or gathering more golden feathers in a tiny world that felt both complex enough to be interesting, but small enough not to overwhelm me. Not having a map was actually a great way to involve players in really discovering the park, playing mindfully, and piecing together a mental map on their own. The bright colors and beautiful little sceneries are so soothing, I'm happy just flying around for a bit without objectives, which you also have to keep track of mentally and get to them whenever you want. And when I felt like I wanted a little challenge, all it takes is talking to the characters and learning more about what they need so that you can find different things to do. Something that was particularly helpful for me were the characters. I love the fact that even though the park is so peaceful and inviting, some of the most memorable characters are individuals with a lot of ambition and drive towards a specific goal, and they can't stay still. There are the rock climbers, the rabbit and tortoise racing, the marathon runners, and Avery. But the most complex side mission centers around an artist moving around the park to capture different landscapes. At first, the artist just seems to be practicing, but we learn that they're nervous about showcasing their art in an upcoming exhibit they've been invited to. And we see them become increasingly panicked about the quality and subject of their work, telling us how afraid they are that what they have to offer won't be good enough or unique enough. They seem to be struggling with some imposter syndrome. A lot of these characters are full of passion and ambition. They're struggling to prove themselves. In such a calm environment, they're pushing themselves to do more and be more, just as Claire is, and perhaps as we are in real life. These characters are troubled by their own self-doubts and worries. We, like them, are taking a moment to enjoy the park, but have other goals we're working towards in the long run. Like Claire, we're taking our minds off the scary things, embracing the scenery and feelings that make us feel strong enough again to handle what we're taking a break from later. By refueling our sense of calm and peace in a game like this, we too can become strong enough to get back to practicing our skills, confronting our self-doubts, or we can work up the courage to be vulnerable and honest. By talking with these characters while we're relaxing and replenishing our emotional resources, it hits a little harder when we see situations like the artists struggle to prove themselves. But also, it becomes all the more inspirational to see them conquer their fears, grow confident in their worth, and return to enjoying their art. I know I gained a lot of encouragement by opening up to the stories, sights, and sounds of this little game. After playing it, I feel reinvigorated and more excited to take on what life has to offer. This is a perfect little comfort game, cozy and warm. A game like A Short Hike is much needed during these tough times, or if you're just having a rough day. We might need to visit Hog Peak when we're feeling overwhelmed by responsibilities or high expectations on ourselves, when we need a gentle reminder of how to practice self-compassion as an antidote to perfectionism, and when we need an hour or two of nourishing self-paced sweetness, curiosity, and rest. Thank you for watching. If you'd like to see more videos analyzing the emotional intelligence of video games, go ahead and subscribe. If you have any suggestions for other titles to cover, please leave a comment. And as always, happy playing.